Hi, today I'm going to show you how to make marshmallows. It's a great thing to do with children. Warning though, children may need parental supervision due to using boiling sugar. If you do get any on your skin, put it straight under cool water for at least 10 minutes. Saying that, it's great fun to do. Kids, you will get sticky, but it's a great treat.
So to start, you will need a saucepan, a tin, a mixing machine or a hand mixer, 20 grams of leaf or powdered gelatin. If you're using leaf, use 6 leaves. Alternatively, you can use veggie gel or agar agar. 120ml of water to mix with your gelatin. 440g of sugar. 100g of glucose, which you can buy at most supermarkets now. Or try alternatives like golden syrup, honey, or even maple syrup. Good tip here, if your glucose is too thick, put the tube in a bowl of hot water to soften it. It's easier to pour. Another 200ml of water. Food colouring, flavouring. Try any type you fancy. I'm doing lemon today. You'll also need 50g of icing sugar and 50g of corn flour for later.
Get all your ingredients ready and a tray lined with greaseproof paper. And spray with a cooking oil, just a light coating. Okay, you're ready to start. Put your powdered gelatin into your mixing bowl. Add the 120ml of water to bloom your gelatin. If you're using leaf gelatin, just put it in cold water until it becomes soft. Remove from water to use. Leave this to one side. Next, put your sugar, your glucose, or your golden syrup, and 200ml of water into your saucepan. You're going to cook this until it reaches a softball stage. Your sugar thermometer is a great thing to have, but don't worry if you haven't got one. I'll show you another method shortly. I'm going to put my syrup on to boil. Do not touch it or stir it. You'll end up with sugar crystals in your syrup, which we don't want. I'll be back in about 10 minutes to show you what it should look like. We need to get to a softball stage. If you don't have a sugar thermometer, you can test by using a glass of cold water. Drop a small amount of sugar syrup into the water. If it dissolves, you need to cook it longer. If strands appear between your fingers, so you need to cook it more. If you can roll it into a little ball, this is the perfect stage. Remove your syrup from the stove. You now need to pour the syrup slowly onto your gelatin. If you use an electric hand whisk, use a large enough bowl to stop sugar spitting out. Whisk at a low speed till a little cooler and it changes colour. Then turn up the speed to whisk faster until it becomes white and fluffy. Now you can add your flavouring and colouring. I'll now show you. You can see the colours change slightly and it's become foamy. This is where you can turn your whisk up. Okay, as you can see, the colour has changed completely. And it's slightly thick. This is where you can add your food colouring and your flavouring. Add little bits of food colouring and flavouring at a time. Kids, this is where you can test it out. Get a spoon, dip it in, taste it. If it needs more, add more. Then continue whisking until quite thick. Check your flavouring. Needs more? Add more. Okay, this is the stage we need to get to, where it's quite thick and almost holds its shape. You need to work quite quickly here, as it sets pretty fast. Get your prepared tray and pour as much as you can into the tray. You may not be able to scrape all of it out, but kids, this is where the messy fun comes in. Help yourselves scrape out the marshmallow goo for yourselves. As you can see, it's getting sticky already. You now need to leave this uncovered overnight if you can, or at least 6 hours. I put mine in an empty oven to stop temptation. Okay, next day you can turn it out. This is what I did previously. So turn it out, and then with your corn flour and sugar mix, just dust liberally over your marshmallow onto a piece of greaseproof to stop it from sticking. Now to cut it to the size you want, get a sharp knife. I tend to dust mine in the corn flour and the icing sugar as well. You can cut these to any shape or size you'd like. Once you've cut them, roll them into the corn flour and icing sugar mix and keep them in an airtight container, if it lasts that long. There you go, that's marshmallows. Great for hot chocolate or toasting, or to eat anytime. You can also try looking on the internet for various different ideas of marshmallows. You can include fresh fruits into a puree, or you can try different versions of gelatin. You can try different types of marshmallows to get different types of thickness or squishability, as I say. You could be firm or really soft. Try different versions, see what you're happy with.